host just an opening statement and then we'll take some questions.
Yeah, you know, I just want to say thank you to our seniors, you know, and the work they put in here. And, you know, we kind of played for them today. You know, looking at the game, I thought we had a really good first half. You know, really good half, you know, half of a third quarter. And then, you know, from there, obviously the turnovers and not getting key stops when we needed them defensively really was the game. So, you know, turn the ball over, then, you know, not being able to get a stop on defense, them going down. Obviously, we gave up the score at the end. We wanted to give them the score so we could have a chance because they could have just sat on the ball and ended the game there with a field goal. So we wanted to make sure we had time offensively to go down and tie the game up. But just, you know, just for the players, feel for them. They worked really hard, had a great week of practice, and, you know, didn't get done what we wanted to get done.
Derek, you know, you guys moved the ball very well for 2.5 quarters. What happened the last quarter and a half? I mean, they shut you out. Again, there were turnovers, but also looked like they were getting more pressure on you.
Yeah. I mean, that's just on us. We got to play better. It's a 4-quarter game. It's not a 2.5 quarter game, so it's just on us. We got to be better.
What happened on the first fumble? Was that? I know it was a low snap to start the whole procedure.
Yeah, I don't know. You know, it happens. I mean, I'll take the blame for it. I just can't have that happen. Can't have the ball on the ground.
Vince, they rushed for almost 10 yards a carry. What made their running game so, you know, and they had 3 runs of over 60 yards. What was the key to their running game, or what weren't you doing?
Well, they, you know, number one rushing attack in the CAA, yep. You understand? So for us, it was our goal to stop the run. We didn't get our job done. We didn't do our job. That's hands down. That's what it comes down to.
No, I can't think of anything else.
Coach, just what do you think the team needs to improve on going into the game against UNH and looking forward to next year?
Yeah, I mean, I think today we didn't tackle well. So, like, you know, right from the start, I mean, we have things that are fit up for, you know, certain positions to make a tackle, and that person's got to make a tackle. If we don't make a tackle, then the ball rips for, you know, however long. And so it's like football is about doing your job, and there's 11 guys doing their jobs, and then, you know, so sometimes things are drawn up where one person has to get it down, or, you know, we have to have guys get on blocks. And obviously the other thing is that we have to clean up is we can't turn the ball over. So you mitigate some of those things. You know, we have the ability to play good defense. We have the ability to move the ball productively down the field, finish drives. We have explosive offense who, you know, we have really, really talented receivers. Obviously, Derek does a tremendous job, and good backs and O-line. And so things are really, you know, coming together from that sense. So a lot of things, positive things there. Obviously, just not getting the outcomes is what, it's hard to validate that outside. You know, inside, I think, you know, all the men in this room and, you know, all the people in the program see those bright spots, and that's, that's promising for what's to come. But I think, you know, if we clean up some of those things in the immediate future, you know, we'll be in a different place at the end of the game. You know, obviously, we're playing a very good New Hampshire team. We're playing Monmouth this next weekend. And then we'll get them down there.
Keenan gave you some, finally your running game got going with Keenan.
What's that?
Your running game finally got going with Keenan.
Yeah. I mean, you know, those guys did a good job. Tristan is he runs hard. He's a tough kid, and so are those other guys. They're tough guys. So it was good to see them get going.
Derek, you lost Gillette like in the first quarter, and then Moss. How much did that impact you not having your top two receivers available?
I mean, yeah, we didn't, you know, those guys are obviously really great players, but I mean, it's next man up. That's how we roll. That's how the game of football works. There's no excuses. It's just next man up, and we just got to get it done.
Seth?
Yep. Seth, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Thanks, guys.